Hey, what's going on, guys? Keith Carpenter here. And in this video, I want to show you something really cool that I think applies to every single person who watches this video that's in the mortgage business or even anybody in any kind of business where the sales cycle is not super quick, right? It's not immediate. It doesn't happen immediately. It takes months, sometimes a year or more for the sale to go through. And that's called a nurture campaign, right? Or sometimes it's known as a long-term nurture, but there could be short and long-term nurture. So right now in this video, I want to show you a way for you to be able to automatically gather somebody's information and then kick off a nurture campaign based off the information that they gave you and the time frame that they're looking at buying. So let's hop over here, and I'm actually going to go through this as quickly as I can because I don't want to keep you too long, but I want to show you how quick and easy and amazing this is so you can see how it will fit in your business. So click on marketing, come down here to form builder, okay? We're going to click on create new form, and I'm going to drag out just a few form pieces here, some basic stuff, because what I want to do is show you the custom form. So let's grab a button here. We'll put that full width, and we'll just say, let's go. Okay. We're going to create a custom form. So I'm going to come over here, come down to custom forms, all the way down to the bottom, click add custom field. And we're going to come down here to single option, and we're going to name this field time frame. Okay, we'll call it time frame. And we're going to say enter your time frame. And then we'll say less than 3 months, 3 to 6 months, 6 months to a year. Okay, so now essentially we're giving this field three options for the person to tell us what their time frame is, right? You could reword this and say, when are you looking to buy? Okay, and then we could call this, you know, time frame, right? Enter your time frame, and that's fine, right? So let's click save, and it's going to go ahead and put this field down here. We're going to pull this over here, drop it at the top, and we're going to say, okay, cool, we got our form, right? Perfect. Now let's go over to pages. Let's go create a new funnel real quick here. We'll call this Keith Test. There's a lot of those hanging around all over the place. We'll go add new step, and we'll say home, and we'll just call this home, and we'll hit create funnel. Okay, so here we are, edit page. So now obviously we're not getting fancy. We just need the form on this page. So I'm going to come over here and just add a row, add a column, and I'm going to add a form, and I'm going to choose my form, form three, the one that I didn't name, and there we are. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and hit save. That's going to open that up in another browser, so we can take a look at that in a second. But I want to do this. What I want to do now is I want to tell the system, hey, listen, if somebody goes in this less than 3 months, they click that, I want to put them in a campaign that's set up to nurture them over the next 3 months, okay? If they go in this one, I want to set up a campaign to nurture them for 6 months, and obviously this one's set up to nurture them for a year, okay? So that's pretty easy, right? But then you say, well, what about the nurture campaigns? What do you write and when do you send them and all that great stuff? I get it, right? But that's why we have it all done for you. So watch this. Automations, we're going to go over here to add a trigger, and we're going to call this less than 3 months. And we're just going to put this in no folder. We'll just say save. Okay. So now we're going to come over here and we're going to say form submitted. And then we're going to add a filter here, and we're going to say form is, and we're going to come over here to form three. And then we're going to add one more filter here because we need to say that the answer to that question that we were looking for is a certain answer. And then which case we can put them in the proper campaign, which is already built out in the system. So we're going to scroll down here and we're going to find the question, when are you looking to buy? That's the question that we asked. And then we have our three answers. So we're going to say less than 3 months, and we're going to go ahead and add an action. And then we're going to say, okay, if they choose this, right, less than 3 months, we want to add them to a campaign. And you can choose a bunch of actions for this, but this is just one action. And we're going to add them to the campaign buyer lead 3 month time frame right here. Okay, there you go. Buyer lead 3 month time frame. Okay, I'm going to hit save. I'm going to hit publish here and activate that. And we'll give the trigger a name. We'll say 3 month nurture. Okay. Save it. And now we have an automation set up, right? We'll do the same thing. So all we're going to do is we're going to go back here. I'm going to take this 3 month nurture. I'm going to duplicate it. I'm going to call this 6 month nurture. Put this in the campaign. I think it's this one right here. Copy. Okay. And then we're going to just duplicate it again. We're going to do 12 month nurture. And there we go. hit copy, and now we're done. So I'm going to go into this 3 month. That one's already done. So let's go into the 6 month, and then let's go to, they chose 3 to 6 months. Okay. And then we're going to put them in the 6 month time frame established, hit save, hit publish and activate. And then we're just going to go back and we're going to hit the 12 month. We're going to tell the system if it's 6 months to a year, put them into the buyer 12 month time frame established, hit save, hit activate. And there we go. Okay. So now when we go back over to this page, which I'm going to do right now, let's just make sure, always make sure your automation triggers are activated. They're all activated. And we're going to go to pages and key test. Let's go here and let's fill this form out. Okay. So I'm going to choose, let's say less than 6 months, put my name in here and my email, and hit let's go. Okay. So, and you can always redirect them to a different page from there. So now we're going to go over to contacts, and there I am. So you can see, I just came into the system. If I click on this here, it's going to bring me into the actual record. And if I scroll down, you can see that now we're in the 3 month time frame established campaign. Okay. Now what is that campaign? Well, let's go take a look. Campaigns, long-term nurture, and let's go into the 3 month time frame established. So down here you have all of the different steps along the journey, right? And the things that are going to go out and the things that are pre-written. Now, if we come back over here to campaigns, let's just go into the one that's a little bit longer. Let's go into the 12 month time frame, and you can see if I open these up, so there's just little messages. This is blank, you know, here I wanted to let you know that I was thinking of you. I know you said you still needed a couple months before you were ready to make a move, but I'm happy to take out to see some properties. You had your eye on if you're interested, right? So there's one. And it just kind of keeps going. It goes right down the list, little touch points, right? And of course you can go through these, right? Make sure that you're cool with them, touch them up, give them your own personality, but you have a guide and you have the frequency of which they're going out. And you know, you have this thing that's automated and you can add to it, make it longer if you want. You know, you could do 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, right? The reality is once you have it built and you start putting people into it, you know, I was talking to somebody recently, you know, and they've been in the business for a long time, the mortgage industry. And, you know, if they had been doing this from the very beginning, imagine the compounding effect, you know, of having a year, you know, years worth of nurture in place for every single lead that comes in, right? Every single one's getting the same exact treatment. Now, here's the question, right? Well, what if they buy, or what if they get approved, or what if they apply, right? Well, it's very easy. The system just takes them off the campaign, right? So we can create an automation that says, if the lead actually applies, then remove them from that campaign, right? So it's really powerful. You think it through and say, okay, well, if they apply, then we don't want to keep sending that, right? Because we're good, or whatever action you're trying to get them to do, you know, you want to make sure that it's encouraging them to do it. Now, obviously this is a real estate snapshot, right? You know, you're not taking people out for homes if you're in the mortgage business, but you know, the same philosophy applies and can be tweaked. In fact, I think we actually have long-term nurture mortgage ones. I just opened this real estate one for this video. So there are ones that apply specifically to mortgage. And again, it's about having that sequence built out, having the time frame separated, and then being able to just go in and plug them in, right? So if you have any questions for me, I'm here. I hope you can see value in this, how you could integrate, you know, some simple forms throughout your web pages or your funnels, and be able to get people to tell you, you know, on that form what they're looking for in the time frame, and then be able to put them into a certain campaign that now does that work for you, you know, and can remove them from the campaign if something else is done along the way. So anyway, enough for this video. I hope you guys found value in this. I hope you see how automation can really help you build something long-term that will continue to grow and compound on itself. So if you need anything, we're here. Reach out and have a great day.